As you know, Ignition comes with a pre-built design environment. That's what Matt was just showing here. Improvements to that platform aren't only meant to be for the plant floor, they're also for accelerating that development process, making it easier, making it quicker to develop things, giving you better tools to use. One of the highlights here is the tag report tool, which actually comes out today. We have the Ignition 8.1.19 release that's happening today that has this tag report tool built in. I'll let Matt show this off. It's a really nice feature that actually has been requested for a long time, and we're happy to finally get this in there. I know the question will also be, is there a tag cross-reference tool? So I'll answer that question before it's even submitted. The answer is that we are going to have that in the next few versions of Ignition here. Those two go together. So the tag report tool and that cross-reference tool are both things that we've been working on internally. So we've released the tag report tool first, and then that cross-reference tool is going to be coming right after that. So over the next few versions of Ignition here. Prospective tooltips, we've allowed for the ability to add tooltips to any component inside Prospective. Resource documentation, this is something that's useful if you're designing a project and you want to allow different folks to work on it at the same time and also document some things along the way. So there's the ability to do documentation on individual resources as part of all of that. We added diagnostic tags for each one of the drivers. So in addition to the values that you see on the gateway web pages, which have been there for a long time, we moved those into tags so that that could be used with things like exchange resources that show those off. You can put those inside your own views. It makes it accessible so that they can have historian added to them or alarms added to them, which is a really nice feature inside there. And then we improved the tag editor pretty significantly as well. We took a lot of feedback from folks who had used the Ignition 7.9 tag editor, and they had feedback for how it would be better inside 8.0 and 8.1. And we took that feedback into account and made some significant improvements to that tag editor, which Matt, I'm going to turn it back over to you and show off each one of those.
Certainly. So yeah, starting from the first one on the list there, we have the tag report tool. And this is a pretty powerful tool overall. So in your tag browser inside the designer here, we now have a new option under the menu for this tag report tool. This allows you to go in and set up different kinds of parameters for what you actually want to query in the tag provider that you have selected there. So we could just do a standard query for anything basically not good, and then do a search and find out, yeah, there's actually an error right here, configuration, something's not actually correct on that tag. So with one click, we can actually see that. We could narrow that down maybe to just only ones with an error and further kind of filter that down. And as you're going through this, you can actually add your custom properties that you need to search for, like what's the tag name, what's something like that, besides what we're showing here. You can also save this search and then come back to it easily later. So again, I could easily just have one set up, find all bad OPC tags, find any name, starts with the word ramp. We do support wildcards in this case here, so we can easily see what's going on, good or bad. And on top of this, we can take this data and actually export it to, say, a CSV file. So that way we get that as part of maybe a standard report that we could submit or save to disk there. So there's definitely a lot of functionality that's going to be useful right there. The next one that we have mentioned is the tooltip. So the tooltips now, if you were to go into your Prospective screen and you kind of drill down into one of your components, you'll actually see at the bottom right of your property tree, this kind of meta information. And there's a whole tooltip object. So we can enable that. We can provide some kind of text here for whatever this is. And now when we say mouse over that, we now have the ability to show that tooltip right there automatically. So you don't have to program that feature yourself, create any kind of pop-up view for that. It's now just simply something that you can set up. And of course you can restyle it. And then because again, these are properties like any other, you can bind to them. On the same note there, kind of globally with the design environment here, you can find the documentation field on all of your resources. So not just perspective views, but certainly any kind of notes you want to add to a given resource. We now have that. We can actually see in the icon here that it is now on there, as well as, you know, another custom one here. And we can actually mouse over that to see the note without having to open up the other view here. So that will certainly be useful. You don't have to, you know, keep notes separately or maybe keep them in a custom property anymore. You can just do that right from the design environment. The diagnostic tags that were mentioned are available under the system tag provider. So every ignition system has this system tag provider, and it has, of course, other types of information, but the one that's highlighted is under your devices. You'll have each device listed there with some standard tags, including whether or not it's enabled, what's the current status of it. So if you want to log this, maybe set an alarm, as Kevin mentioned, so when it's not running, someone's alerted immediately, then you can now do that. And these are tags like any other. You could bring them right into a screen or go into the new tag editor here and actually start editing those tags. So on that note, if I look at any standard tag here, what we've done is we've added a category pane so we can easily kind of tab through all of the different property categories here, especially ones like the alarms and the scripting, which would traditionally kind of take over the editor here, and you'd have to flip back and forth as you edit those. Now I can easily just kind of sort through that rather quickly. So yeah, any kind of, you know, improvement, of course, we can do to something that's used regularly like this, of course, we are definitely interested in that. And of course, any kind of feedback, any other further improvement, definitely let us know, and we'll happily take that all into consideration. And again, if you go through this all property section, and then you click on something, you know, like changing the security, you can see we automatically highlighted that. So again, we can go back and forth rather quickly.